श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्य कवितार्किककेशरि वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि नमो नारायण. लेट्स कंटिन्यू टू एंजॉय द वंडरफुल वैभवम द ऑफ वेदांत देशिका 750th बर्थडे सेलिब्रेशंस दिस इयर एंड ऑन दैट वी डू अ our might to contribute on Acharya Sarvabhauman. There is one Stotra Mala, Srimad Vedanta Desika Vishayaka Stotra Mala, where the Stotras on Swami Desikan, praising his glories, praising his scholarship and Acharyans Jnana Bhakti Vairagya Anushtanams. All these stotrams have been composed by several acharyas after Desikan, and we are enjoying one after the other in that series. Today's verse or stotram is Srimad Vedanta Desika Vigraha Dhyanam. Vedanta Desika was an acharya unparalleled, and he has contributed or he has authored more than 120 works in Sanskrit, Tamil, Prakritam, Manipravalam, and based on philosophical works, based on devotional works, Ragasya Grantham, esoteric works, and Tamil Prabandhams. And the only aim that was focused by Desikan in his 100 years was to kind of establish and build a fort of Vedanta system, as beautifully laid out and formulated and propagated by Emperumanar Bhagavad Bhashyakarar Ramanuja. And to protect Ramanuja Darshanam and Ramanuja Siddhantam Visishtadvaita Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya against the attacks from rival schools, Vedanta Desika shown illustriously, and he did marvels at that on all those works, and no acharya can match the works of Swami Desikan. The extent, the number, the quality and the quantity of Swami Desika's works. This Desika Mangala Vigraha Dhyanam, విగ్రహ లోకాన పరః తస్య చాజ్ఞా ప్రతిక్షకః ఆచార్య దివ్యమంగళ విగ్రహం దెమ్సెల్స్ ఆర్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ కాంటెంప్లేషన్ అండ్ ధ్యానం ఫర్ ద సత్శిష్యాస్ ఆఫ్ ద శిష్యాస్ సో ద శిష్యాస్ నీడ్ టు కాంటెంప్లేట్ ద దివ్యమంగళ విగ్రహం ఆఫ్ స్వామి దేశికన్ ఆర్ ఆచార్య అండ్ మెడిటేట్ ఆన్ ఆచార్యాస్ లోటస్ ఫీట్ And that is the way Melayar Saivanagal. That's the way erudite scholars and acharyas, elders have prescribed. And especially for the ignoramuses and the stupid folks like me, instead of reading his works and trying to understand his works, it's better to contemplate on his divine form, Tirumeni. And Swami has written so beautifully this work. సో శ్రీమాన్ శ్రీమన్ లక్ష్మణ యోగీంద్ర సిద్ధాంత విజయధ్వజం విశ్వామిత్ర కులోద్భూతం వరదార్య మహంభజే కంపోజ్డ్ బై వరదాచార్య కుమార వరదాచార్య హిస్ సన్ సో అండ్ ఐ వుడ్ సెండ్ యూ ద పీడిఎఫ్ వెర్షన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ వేదాంత దేశిక విగ్రహ ధ్యానం అడియన్ వుడ్ జస్ట్ గివ్ ద ఇంగ్లీష్ ఈక్వలెంట్ ఆఫ్ ద వర్క్ ఆఫ్ ద స్తోత్రంస్ ద ఫస్ట్ స్తోత్రం స్వామి సేస్ Even though he is Sarvatantra Swatantra, he is a Paratantran for Bhagavatas. Means he considers himself as the servant of the Bhagavatas, Paratantran. Even though he was declared and called by Divya Dampati as Sarvatantra Swatantra. That is the greatness of my Nathan, Venkatanathan. And for that, Venkatanathan, may my mind the bouquet of the flower excite him and entice him and let it make him happy. That's what Swami Kumara Vardhacharya says in the first sloka. And in the second sloka, he says, Sri Venkateshan, the Acharya Vallal, the most compassionate benefactor Acharya, the one who has the most beautiful form, and one who considers the lotus feet of Kidambi Kulapati Appullar as the Devam, as the only God for him. And oh mind, please think of this Acharya Vallal at all times. That's the second stotra. And in the third stotram, Swami Desikan is compared as the very, his Trimeni, his divine body, is like the shining sun. And the sun from the lotus feet up to the Tirumudi, the Samudaya Sobai, the totality in its entirety, the Trimeni, it should appear in my eyes, even when the eyes are closed inside at all times, so that Adiyan can contemplate his divine form. And Tupul Trivenkatesha Guru is like the shining sun. Fourth verse, the two lotus feet are like the just freshly bloomed red lotus flower. And even the red lotus flower feel ashamed because of the, when it looks at the beauty of the twin, the pair of lotus feet of Swami Desikan. And the white shining nails at the toe are like the moonlight, and it sheds light. Thereby, it dispels the darkness from our mind. And all those who contemplate or look at these beautiful lotus feet and the nails will get their ignorances of darkness completely dispelled by these nails and the lotus feet. Fifth stotram. Here, he says, the Divyalaga Panktiyagira Ratriyoda Chenda Ashtami Chandran Pondra Trinetri. His divine face, Tirumukham, has got the crescent like the forehead. It's just like the Pirai Chandran, the crescent moon. So that crescent moon like the forehead has got a shining, beautifully worn Urdhva Pundram, Thiruman Sri Churnam, which is so beautiful to look at when you look at Swami's effulgent, that beautiful face, the shining Tejas face, and that forehead on which the beautiful Urdhva Pundram, and you can see the white long grey colored long shikai on his head, and because of that he looks as if he is the other form of Namalwar himself, Shatakopa himself, with the long white hair and the forehead and the Urdhva Pundram. Next, the sixth verse. From the moon-like face, from that, the moon rays come down to the earth. Similarly, the white beard comes up to his chest. And on that chest, there is a pure white Yajnopavitam, the punol, on his chest. And around his neck, the tulasi and lotus mala necklace is there. The tulasi mala and the lotus mala, lotus bead mala. Here the garland he has worn as a Sri Vaishnava Lakshanam. So, and then the Kumara Vardhacharya's eye slowly, like in a wave, when there is a leaf on the wave, the wave automatically takes, the leaf automatically takes where the wave goes, and it gets transferred from one wave to the other wave. Similarly, his vision goes from one part of Desikan's Trimeni to the other part automatically without his knowledge. And now he shifts his vision to the calf muscle from the divine chest to the calf muscle, and it talks about the calf muscles are like the ambara toni, where the arrows are kept, the bag. It's so stout and strong, and it is golden colored. Similarly, this golden colored the arrow bag is actually conquered by the calf, the beauty of the calves. And the knee is like the oxen or the bull's head neck. So the bull has got a hump on the top, and the knees are so beautiful, like the bull's humps. And those two knees completely stupefy me, Swami says. 8th verse, where he says this, the banana trunk, you know, the banana tree's trunk, that trunk, the banana tree, it is quite, it feels proud that it is so beautiful, the trunk itself, until it sees Swami Desikan's thighs. So the thighs are much more beautiful than the banana trunks, and he has got a white uttriyam, the vastram, on his waist, and such so beautifully his long legs and the knees and the calf muscle above the lotus feet, with the white waist cloth tied around, is beautifully seen by Kumara Vardhacharya. 9th verse, here he talks about the curly navel on his belly, and he has got the large, wide, broad chest, and the two long limbs which touch up to the knee, and he has got the strong shoulder raised, and the neck bones are completely hidden. It's not protruding out. The neck bones are not visible. It is covered by the neck flesh. And Swami Desikan's, the divine chest, the large chest, the strong shoulder, the long limbs up to the knee, and the neck are all so beautiful to behold in our eyes, Swami says. And finally, the tirukaluthu, the neck, is completely belittles the white conch shell, and the long ears are unparalleled. It's so beautiful. And the mandahasam, the slight smile, the impish charm smile in his face, with preeti, with vatsalyam, with welcoming eyes, and that red coral lips which are like soft tender mango leaves. And then that's the way his divine face looks, and inside that red coral lips and the mouth are the pearls kept in an order, in an array, and those are the white milky teeth. And above that mouth, beautiful curvy lips, is the long creeper like nose, which is like a sesame creeper, yet poo. The sesame flower is compared with the nose, yet poo nasi, they say in Tamil. So even the creeper nose is so beautiful when you look at the lips and above the sharp aquiline nose. And from that creeper-like nose, in the 12th verse, Swami says, the creeper, the karpaga kodi pu, the kalpaka vriksham creeper, which is the nose, and above that creeper is the are the two lotus flower, which are the eyes. And in that beautiful red lotus flower, there are two bees which are caught, and they are arrested by the beauty of the eyes, beauty of the lotus flowers, and those are the two eyeballs. So the poetic imagery is so beautiful by Swami. The two flowers, red lotus flowers, and there are two bees in that flowers, which are completely stupefied by inhaling the fragrance of the flower, and because of that they are intoxicated and they are unable to move, and they are so beautiful, the bees within the red flower. And that's how Swami's two eyes are so beautiful to look at. So next is Sujata Charanambujam Shudrada Kulpa Januarukam. Here he talks about the entire Trimeni, the red lotus feet and the strong calf muscles, the strong knees and the banana trunk like the thighs and the waist cloth. Afterwards, the curvy, curly nabi, the navel, the chest, the neck, the two long limbs, the chubby cheeks, the creeper-like nose, and the beautiful lotus flowers, the tulasi nalinaksha mala, the tulasi and the lotus bead malas on the divine chest. O Trivenkatanatha, my guru, O mind, please praise him again and again. From the Tirumudi to Tirivadi of Swami Desika. So beautifully Kumara Vardhacharya explains in totality, in its entirety, the beauty of Swami Desika. Thus, Swami Desikan, Trivenkatanathan Guru, who is the most compassionate Guru and who has Mandahasam, smiling face, always in his Trimukha Mandalam, and who has the white Uttriyam on his waist, and who has tulasi and lotus bead as the mala on his divine, strong, wide, large chest, and who has the most beautifully worn adorning his forehead as Urdhva Pundram, and who has Sankh Chakra on his right and left shoulders, that this Swami Desikan's Trimeni Divyamangala Vigraham should always be in my heart under all circumstances and in my mind, so that I can behold his form in the cavity of my heart as well as in my eyes. Ya imam dinacharyamcha vigraha dhyana paddhatim varadarya kritam bhaktya shilayet mukta yevasaha. Thus the vigraha dhyanam, which is composed by Varadacharya, if one recites this with bhakti, they would be blessed with mokshanandam here itself, in this birth itself. Kavitarkika simmaya kalyana gunashaline srimate venkateshaya vedhanta gurave namaha. Adiyan.